Hi guys, today we are at Boulder Plus, which is an awesome climbing gym in Singapore. If you climb here, you will know them. They have two locations, one at Kallang in Imperial Mall, and the one that we're at today, which is the new, recently opened location at the Chevrons. Now, I have actually been here before, and I'm so excited every time I come here because it is now the largest indoor bouldering space in Singapore. I did try to come last time and vlog it, but sadly, because I was an idiot sandwich, I forgot audio. It was like a silent film from 1910. So today we're doing things right, and they have actually reset the walls since I was last here, so there is new stuff to climb, climbing fresh problems, and I'm just really stoked to show you what this amazing bouldering space in Singapore is like. So let's do it. Hey, Sean. We got the 8 a.m. slot on a Sunday. Rate that, what is that? It's a blue tag, which is before the middle of the noob scale. Good. Nope. 10 minutes into our slot here and you're trying this down dyno already. I found down dyno is really scary. I'm scared that my foot will pop and that my shin will just go into the hold instead, which is why every time I get ready to do it, I just can't follow through. I'm too scared. Just a really nice flowy climb. Really enjoyed it. Very mentally middle section, and this hold right here is a bit scary because it's slippery. It's not the grippy side, but you just gotta focus on this motion, mantle, and the rest comes very nicely. I enjoyed that climb. But that middle section was so awkward for me. Jammed in there. Climbing dance moves. Chimney. Mantle. Engage. One, two, three. Chimney, mantle, engage. I need to warm up into that. Pretty jumpy. I think I was kind of just moving based on instinct. I'd like to do that a few more times to just refine the movement. I notice, and people always tell me that I exhale breath like a lot. And you can always hear me. I'm the only one in the climbing gym making that noise. And I've carried it over from Muay Thai. Whenever I need to exert energy, I just go, you can hear me in a climbing gym before you can see me, because I'm the one who's just exhaling my way up the climb.
Everything's bad. The holes are bad. The foot holes are bad. I'm bad.
You're not bad. You're so good.
I keep getting stuck at all the hand holes over there. The green in three in a row.
Oh yeah, yeah.
They're kind of like jaggy at the right angles, but then because the wall's inclined and the foot holes like don't give you that much to edge on, so it feels like you're constantly like slipping off.
As I've seen, there's not really a youth team to climb in.
So if you're talking about kids, right, there are those in primary school that's 7 to 12 years old. Usually the only sports or any extracurricular activities that they do is done from school. And not every school offers bouldering or rock climbing as a sport that they can choose from. And the only other way that they'll get into the sport is by their parents. But in Singapore, because we don't have a lot of natural rocks, not many hills and mountains, right? So I think it's in general, it's not very popular. Only recently, the indoor bouldering scene has gotten like much more popular. Now, if you look at, especially from secondary schools to polytechnics and junior colleges, they offer a lot more accessibility to bouldering now and rock climbing in general. Yeah, we have a lot of competitions that are being set up by, you know, people who kind of like pioneered the bouldering scene, I think. But that's not for me to say.
Yeah, I'll try that. Come on. Okay, let's try it together. To move the feet too soon, but I feel like it will go. Let's keep trying. It's pretty difficult to navigate in that position. The rock over is quite challenging.
Nice. This exact move, trying to get your body over to the other side.
Yeah,
that's very hard. Actually, I think I could have done it, but
I
messed up the next move. So I was a bit too rushed.
There are a lot of serious bouldering videos out there, which I love and appreciate. But on the lighthearted end of the spectrum, it's also nice to just see people having fun and being part of a local inner city bouldering community, because those are on the rise and they're a really great thing to be a part of if you can. Come on, Sean. It spat you out, dude.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna try this yellow crimpy climb, which I think I'll like because it's crimpy. I mean, I'm told that it's quite challenging because there's like high feet and it forces you into really cramped positions. So let's just see. That move is going to be hard for me, transitioning from here to that hold on the side. My bouldering style is chalk and talk. I like to keep a 50-50 ratio of both, make that 60-40. Is this a nice catch?
It's good enough.
Dude, that is not nice. Sean's idea of a jug. I'm just being too jumpy. If I could be more controlled, then I wouldn't need to shock load my fingers as hard on that hold, but it's because I'm jumping for it. We need to engage. Engage. Do you regret your decision to come here so early in the morning?
No, I love climbing.
Your love for climbing knows no hours.
Yes, that's right.
Has no opening hours. Okay, what do you think of Boulder Plus Chevrons?
I think the gym is really nice. It's very big. It's one of the biggest in Singapore that I've seen, I think. The problems are very big, they're very nice. Everything looks just very aesthetic and it's just a very pleasant place
to be. It is very nice.